During Uganda's 62nd Independence Day celebrations that were held today at Masafu Town Council in Busia District, President Yoweri Museveni urged Africans to abandon the politics of identity and embrace pan-Africanism as the cornerstone for social and political transformation. The president emphasized that economic prosperity and social development can only be achieved through unity and collaboration amongst African nations, highlighting the importance of a unified African market.
I cannot end this address without again emphasizing the importance of the African economic and political integration in whatever we are doing in regard to the two historical missions, prosperity for the African people and the strategic security.
The president further highlighted the importance of socio-economic transformation and emphasized the role of production, adding that the population should change from working hand to mouth, but rather engage in production for the market.
We are first of all to tackle the mistake of allowing big sections of our population to remain outside the money economy. Our colleague Chida Chionka, working only for the stomach. According to the latest census data, finally 67% of our people are in the money economy.
During the celebrations, the Minister for the Presidency, Millie Babalanda, raised concern over the high level of corruption. She referred to a recent IGG report on corruption implicating politicians and public servants, a report she termed highly disturbing.
For the stability and transformation of the country, you have also nurtured many young leaders. After 62 years of independence, we have built a critical mass of leaders.
The Office of the Prime Minister, OPM, through the Prime Minister Delivery Unit, PMDU, together with the National Curriculum Development Center, started an engagement with York Express, a renowned education publisher, to advance the education sector in Uganda. During the engagement in March in Kampala, Robert Kasule, the head of the Prime Minister Delivery Unit, PMDU, said that this collaboration would help advance Uganda's education to match dynamic global standards.
The objective of today's interaction is clear: to have an open, in-depth discussion on how we can collaboratively work towards enhancing Uganda's education through curriculum design.
Dr. Bernadette Nambi, the deputy director at NCDC, reiterated the need for this collaboration, which she believes will offer a great learning experience for the National Curriculum Development Center, NCDC, to improve the education sector in Uganda.
That if we come up with an education system which is wanting, as a country we shall be left behind. So this, I'm hopeful that this discussion will take us to greater heights.
You do need to learn certain skills for certain job areas that directly affect this country. But it doesn't mean that you just have to learn those skills and leave the academia behind. And the same thing will apply with learning academic. You can be academic, but also learn lifelong skills while doing it.
Kenyan lawmakers swiftly moved the Senate on Wednesday in a bid to oust Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua after the lower house of parliament impeached him in an unprecedented political drama that has gripped the nation. The National Assembly voted overwhelmingly last night to impeach Gachagua in a historic move that follows an acrimonious falling out with his boss, President William Ruto. The impeachment motion accused the 59-year-old Gachagua of corruption, insubordination, undermining the government and practicing ethnically divisive politics, amongst a host of other charges that he has ferociously.
It is so unfortunate that they turned up in large numbers to go and impeach deputy president, and yet there are other factors that are affecting us which they cannot deal with them as they dealt with that issue of impeachment of the deputy president.
And it is now Gachagua for himself, but at the end of the day, the MPs they did a good thing. Feel like the whole presidency has failed the country.
The impeachment motion accused the 59-year-old Gachagua of corruption, insubordination, undermining the government and practicing ethnically divisive politics, among a host of other charges that he has all vociferously denied. It was approved by 282 MPs in the 349-member National Assembly, more than the two-thirds required, after a sometimes heated 12-hour session. Fast-tracking the next stage of the process, the upper house was in session today to hear the charges against Gachagua, with Senate Speaker Amason Jaffa Kingi telling lawmakers, "We are expecting a heavy day." The Senate has 10 days to wrap up the proceedings and decide on the motion, which requires the support of at least two-thirds of the senators to pass.